Look at him boil it up.
Oh, whoa! There he is!
Nice fish, Rob.
Rob Crandall is your host in this detailed look at the whys and the ways of spey fishing steelhead in cold water. His goal in this angling instructional is to help you understand that cold water steelheading demands different tactics.
Now, by adjusting my approach, throwing my line more upstream in this situation, get my three steps in again, those are ways that we can get the fly deeper earlier in the swing. It's what we call the slip, step, swing trick. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna make that same distance cast. We make the mend. We allow that line to slip up here that we tie the fly on with. That combined with a little bit of chop on the surface really helps fish this fly nicely across. Now fly size, color, and weight are all other variables that play into your swung fly success. Weighted flies were good to help get the fly down deeper. Unweighted flies, great in those long flats where you can dial in the depth with the sink tip alone.
Rob is joined on occasion in this look at spey fishing cold water steelhead by a pair of experts, Dean Finnerty and Marty Shepherd. They give us additional tips and demonstrations, plus provide us the chance to see some action on their favorite rivers.
The speed of the fly in the swing needs to slow down a bunch in the wintertime because of the colder water and that metabolic rate of these fish. And your movement downstream, I'm an advocate of slowing everything down.
I don't know if you can see what's happening here, but I'm just gonna give you one example right here. If you can see my line. If I go too fast right here, you see I've sent all that energy straight upstream.
We're hoping the lessons provided here will get you a few more of those tugs when the water is cold.
And we're off. There's a steelhead, my friends. Yes. Oh, and it's taking line. Keeping the line tight as best you can. What a powerful fish.